All right, hey creators, Jonathan here. Got a new toy. Thank you creators on YouTube for helping me with this one. Whoop, it's getting camera there. So I needed some circles. I haven't shaved today. Anyways, I got, what am I doing? I'm waffling on screen. Anyways, so I got this 175. I got this 175, and I just got this. This is it's a JBL. It's a JBL horn. And we're going to be incorporating it into the JBL project with the 075s and whatnot. This one's going to be mated to the 175, but it has a 2-inch hole and mouth. And my driver here, my mid driver, you can probably see that there in the dot there in the middle of the three dots. This is a 1-inch hole. So I started drawing pictures. So one of the things I'd like to point out is that, so metal, I started my horn game with, some Altec horns, and the Altec horns that I had were, you know, the cheapest ones with the mouth slots in the middle. And people started doing like tar on the outsides of them. And, I just couldn't get past the metal ringing part. I have some tinnitus issues. So any amount of metallic ring in the sound upsets me. I found later Western Electric made these big horns out of wood. And if you go on to YouTube and watch any videos where they talk about Western Electric 15A. That is a massive wood horn. I mean, it's like, it's big. I don't know, let's say 4 feet by 4 feet. So it's a big mouth. And they use a pretty good sized driver on the back of that. This is a miniature game that I'm playing right now, but I'm not trying to do a whole theater. I'm just doing like a living room. Anyways, yeah, so I have a disparity between the driver mouth of 1 inch and the mouth of this metal ring of 2 inches. And as I believe, I knew what I was buying, and I knew that JBL does make an adapter that goes from 1 inch to 2 inch, but it too is metallic. And I've been drawing pictures of like what would I do here, and I've got some pictures that go all the way to a complete wood horn, but right now I kind of want to learn this idea. See the one there with the, that's this horn. You probably see the side of it here, so that's that, and then the little puck in the back is the driver. The wood spacers thing that goes between the two, that is going to soften the initial attack of the tweeter. So it will go through like a coupler. So I needed a circle to, gosh darn it. I needed a circle of wood, four thicknesses of plywood, to sandwich between the Alnico driver, there we go, the Alnico driver and the wood metal horn, which takes it from a circle to a 160 degree dispersion. So I've been looking at a lot of these horns online, and like TAD is a nice horn from, I believe it's Pioneer, ultimately Pioneer, I believe, owns TAD. I could be wrong with that. Who knows? Anyways, they have a beautiful horn, and a lot of people make that horn for their living rooms. And I'm sure it's awesome, but that's, I think, overkill. I'm like really envisioning kind of like two people listening, either on a love seat or maybe a couch, in between these three speakers that I have planned. And the center channel, or the center section, is a heavier bass unit with a mid-range. And this is the mid-range element that I'm talking about. So, 160-degree dispersion, meaning left to right. Like, if I angle it just right, you know, like, this would be like a circle. That would be like a circle shooting at you if I had no horn on the front of it, and it was just the circle, you know, blowing right at you out of the horn driver there, with no horn. And then it goes into this fan where it sort of cups the sound, and then it spreads it out to 160 degrees, which I think is probably like, so this 160 degrees, it was originally released by JBL as a floor wedge monitor. So that is for a musician standing in front of a microphone and playing, say, guitar and singing and needing to hear the sounds from the rest of the band as mixed by the side mixing guy for the monitor mixes. So anyways, yeah, it's a pretty tight dispersion, and that gives you the ability, 160 degrees. They actually, in their application, they placed this in a vertical manner because as you play guitar, you don't always sing. Sometimes you're walking back, and then that would be changing the sweet spot. If you can imagine, if it's like 160 degrees like this, and you go further back and forward, you're gonna get a pretty good image. If you walk away from the monitor, like, you know, this way and this way, you're gonna lose it. But as I stated, we're doing the couch and I'm turning it sideways. So if I angle it just right off the top of the bass cabinet, I should be able to get, you know, a headshot on the couch, watching a movie or chilling, listening to music. I'm trying to get that camera and talking to it, but I still like to see me. I'm a noob. Anyways, the point of this whole video, besides showing, was to say thank you to the creators who have taught me how to use my new toy here, this Ryobi little handheld thing, and how to make this cool jig so as to make circles. I have a whole little wood pile down here. It's kind of hard to see what I'm doing. But anyways, there we go. That's worse. Fucking about. Anywho, yeah. Thank you very much, creators. Thank you for sharing. I'm also trying to share and give back to anyone who's interested in JBL components, as that's the program I'm working on right now, is a stereo playback for record player. I've been buying record player bits. There's the other 075 that I've been working on, but this is a that's part of my RecoCut stuff. There's some shoes. I just got some new shoes off eBay. Anyways, yeah, a little sideways action there. Just saying thank you to the creators who've helped me make this jig and figure out how to make these plywood donuts. I'm also planning a plywood final sandwich after the donuts. So it'll go magnet driver into wood. So the first bounce of mid-range frequencies will be going through a wooden section. It'll then hit the horn, which will go from continuation of circle to a 160 degree fan. And then it'll go to a final 2 3-quarter inch sections of plywood. So it'll go driver, wood, horn, wood. So as to the last thing the frequency rolls across would be wood. Just trying to soften the metallic sound, like if you had a 100% metal horn, which I think is the 811. The 811 horn was the one I'm referencing. I just didn't like that, and I ended up selling those just because I didn't feel like chasing that rabbit down the hole. Yeah, so right now I'm doing a halvesy, and it's sort of, I kind of know that a wood horn, all the way wood, would be better, and I do have a design for that, but I kind of wanted to understand the 160 degree dispersion. The TAD is a much wider dispersion, and I'm wondering, you know, for, I'm firing from, you know, maybe a 10 foot, 12 foot, 20 foot type thing, like to fill a living room. So I'm not really trying to fill, like I said, a concert space. I'm really just trying to do like a living space. You know, I'm imagining a living room of normal Southern California tininess. I'm already gonna have massive speakers in this room, so it's gonna be overkill anyways for the compression of the room. So I'm trying to like baby step into it and not overkill the situation. Which I see most systems on Instagram, which I love, are adaptions of theater systems. And these theater systems, they were, you know, a pair of A7s were meant to do the job of, you know, 10x volume of what these people are using them for in their living rooms. It's just ridiculous. And I realize that that's kind of the tools that are left after, you know, the theaters have moved on. And these are the things that people are able to get a hold of without like buying all the frickin' tools and like getting into, you know, making their own jigs and stuff. Without all of that effort of like shrinking stuff down, taking the concepts of the big boys like JBL and Altec and Western Electric and Bell Systems, without taking all of the intel from them and boiling it down to what a living room size is, you just sort of grab what they left in their wake. You know, they needed to provide sound for movie theaters, and they took all of their study and they made all of their angles and all of their, you know, magnet structures and speakers and all of that effort into the tools that we're playing with today. And for a lot of it, it's a lot of overkill. A lot of overkill. So I like overkill as well. So it's understandable why you would take theater equipment and put it in your living room. For one, it's architecturally cool. It's big. Like I have a singular, this is a Klipshorn. It's a 1950s Klipshorn right here. This guy, big old speaker goes in the side hole there. don't know if we saw that or not, but it's a bigger thing. And you know, like a lot of speakers today are small, like this, you know, like the size of, you know, your hand. So like how is this like good for a lot of people? And then some people who are more, you know, more into it, why do they need a whole refrigerator size box? Well, because you do. We like overkill. Anywho, I think I've gone on long enough here, and why I'm using the tools I'm using and why I'm using smaller horns. Still, I mean, this is also a horn that can go quite large. I'm just using the focusness and the directionality of it to sort of leapfrog me ahead in study. Is 160 degree dispersion good enough? Am I happy with that? Do I want to extend it to more of like, you know, 200 degree dispersion? Does that make it less, you know, pointy? I don't know. We'll see. That's the lesson. And I'm going to keep going. And I'll report back. And I'll show you more pictures of this stuff. And if you guys don't have time to watch me talk shit for a lot of time, you could just check me out on Instagram. I'm on Instagram. I got a couple accounts there. I've got Jolly Roger. Jolly69 Roger. That's one account. Avatar Manifesto, that's another account. Mill Hill Sonic Designs, that's another. That's my three accounts for gear. I've got a DJ site, DJ Wico, but that's not really developed out yet, and I'm not really focusing on DJing yet. I'm sort of more focusing on the hi-fi aspects right now. Also, Affected Effects. We just ran a program here. Let's see if I can get some bunnies. We got all these bunnies. I'm still building bunnies in my spare time. This company. There we go, Affected Effects and the pink bunny. So I got racks on racks on racks of pink bunnies still to build. All these and these in line, and those bunnies still being born down there. Yeah, I'm pretty productive in the electronic stuff. I also take pictures. That's Kensington 9 West. But that's all girls, so if you're not into girls, probably don't want to go there. I think that's about it. All right. Thank you, creators. Like and subscribe.